Hi, I'm Francis here. Today, I want to talk to you about 7 phases that you can take your customer from a completely stranger to a high-paying customer on your website. If you love how to do it, you should watch the whole entire video. Just stay tuned for it. Point number 1, you need to determine the temperature of the traffic. The temperature of the traffic, it means that do you know that person or do the person know about the solution? And it's just like an old school selling, right? If you are a real estate agent or if you are an insurance agent, mostly the first thing that they talk about is the temperature of the lead. If you are an insurance agent, they will talk about your parents. If they don't have any health policy, you should sell it to them because it's very beneficial. So they are most likely to buy it from you. That's what it means. It's no different when it's come to online marketing. We do need to understand that what are the temperature of the customer. But the thing is it's slightly different because most of the retail product people have an idea and know who they are, and you can interact with them to see what state or what stage they are at. But with internet, you can't do it. Here are the things that determine the temperature of the customer, which is ranging from: are they unaware of the problem? And then it's going to be problem aware. And then if they're aware of the problem, then they will aware of the solution. And then the next phase is going to be they aware of the product. And then the last phase would be the most aware. So we put it very simple, which is if I do have a problem which I want to solve, let's say for example, I don't know how to do swimming. If I'm in the phase 1, I don't aware of it or I don't really care of swimming. So most likely, most people would not sell me anything. So that's a phase 1. And then in the phase 2, which is the aware of the problem, which means that I may have to go to a boat trip or cruise trip. I aware that if I don't know how to swim, that could be a trouble, right? So I aware of the problem. That is the first step to solving anything. The second step would be a solution aware. It means that they know there's a way that people solve this problem. For example, people may be watching a YouTube video, maybe hiring a coach so they could learn how to swim. Those are the solution aware. But when they're aware of the solution, then they would probably pick a product or anything that is solving the problem. And those people are product aware. It means that they are probably picking the best way or product for them to solve their problem. So those are probably the hardest lead. All you need to do probably is come out with the best offer and persuade them why your product would be the best and they would buy from it. And those are the way that you can psychologically distinguish all the temperature of the truck. Once you identify the traffic, which is the most important phase, in my opinion, because when you understand that, you can send them to different landing page, which we call the bridge page. What it means that it's just because if they are unaware of any problem, but they do face the problem, we can send them to a landing page or a video or any headline to educate them or let them know they may face the problem in their life. Maybe persuade them why they need to be aware of this problem. If you are acting now, it could help them to prevent future pain and have more joy in their life, right? So that's why you can imagine the people who are going to see the page of that person would be different than those people who are very hard aware of everything and they're just looking for the best product they could buy. With that in mind, so we would have a bridge page. You can match that bridge page to the specific temperature of that customer, so we can make sure that they are all come up to the same level when it's come to next phase. When the next phase, I would call a quality subscriber. It means that if they come through the door of the bridge pay and from the traffic, and you need to find a way to connect with your customer. Otherwise, that is just like when you go to a party and everyone is stranger to you. They don't know you and you don't know them. And you know that when you walk out of the party, you will never see those people again. The only way that you can know that person and talk to that person again is ask for some kind of contact information from them. So that is actually the same thing. We want to ask them to be on our subscriber or either on the YouTube form, Instagram form, or your email list form. And the best way that we do it is actually we provide value to them. Let's say we are selling bowling lesson. All we can do is if you want a 5 tricks for beginner to master how to get the first 1,000 points or something like that, you can give us the email address and name. You can subscribe to our list, and in exchange, we will give you the quick 5 tips or hack that they can use right now. I mean, that is actually very important. The reason for that is, like, if those people are very serious about learning bowling, they would actually give them the email to exchange for information. Or if they don't do that, probably means that the thing that you're giving to them is not valuable enough, they don't want that. But let's say your thing, the offering, is very valuable. There's no reason they have serious interest on the subject that you're offering, and they would not subscribe to it. So that's why this is very important. And then with the phase four, that's quality buyer. The best time for you to sell a customer, it isn't like 5 minutes or 5 days or 10 days or 20 days from the time they subscribe to the list. Those people who subscribe to your list, they obviously show some interest. You want to offer them something to buy. Like, at that time, you want to offer something high in value, low in price. It's just like a 1 foot hurdle people would hop over. So it means that those people who want to buy from you, you would get the trust from them. Those people who are buying are tend to buy, because people will only buy from those people who they trust and like. When you provide enough value, and when the price point is very low, and then the product that they get, perceived value, is about 10 times to 20 times of what they pay, they would pay for it, right? So once they have the habit of paying for this guy, of this content, they kind of make a mental commitment to buying it from you. They know that I paid $10 to this guy, everything is as his promise, and he seems like a good guy, and he delivered everything that he say he would deliver. So you actually get the trust from them, right? So that would be the best way you can build trust or see who are those quality buyers. And this phase that I described would be the best suit to just happen after they subscribe to your list. The reason is, like, when they say that they are interested in the specific product, it means that everything that they think at this moment is very fresh. You don't want people to say to buy from you like 5 days from now. It's just like when you go to a party. If you know someone, like, from a party, even a girl that you want to get the number, or people that you want to networking with, and after you get that phone number or get that email, you want to send them a email or like a text or something on the next day, not 5 years from that day or like a 5 days from that day, because people will forget. Maybe you like them, or you want to see them, like, that is on your mind a lot, but, like, you don't know what the other customer or what the other end thinks about you, right? So you want to make sure that hit the thing when the iron is hot. But of course, you have to provide quality offer and quality product to the customer. Then you know who are those people are very, very good prospect from your list. And then the phase five, you want to identify the hyperactive buyer. What it means that is, like, those people who subscribe to a list, they're hoping for something. So they're hoping of either improving their skill, either like looking for some kind of equipment that they cannot buy or cannot find online, or they're looking for education, or they're looking for the shortcut to either get the product or anything, right? So those people wanted to improve on whatever they are looking for. Those people are in pain, they're agitated, they wanted to improve. You want to identify those people, because those people would pay for anything that you promised them that you could deliver, and it actually can help them. So that is actually valuable. So you wanted to send an offer to them, so you know who are those people actually, like, purchase the more expensive item, which is different than the one that I talk about. But the time between that would be a little bit longer, because you want to explain to them why you have a better product and why you're a good guy to buy from. Those are the things that would happen when they subscribe to your list. And then with phase six, which is nurturing the list. What it means that is, like, you want to have a group of people who listen to you on that subject matter. What it means that, like, you want to provide value to them. If initially you're only selling bowling shoes or anything like that, right? So you want to provide why yours better and how to improve your bowling skill, or, like, you want to do some interview of, like, a bowling guy, because, like, those people who love bowling, they would love that content. If you make that content, you're basically just nurturing that relationship. You provide a lot of value to them. Once you want to ask them to buy something, or you have some offer to present to them, they, like, guilt them into buying your product. As long as like you provide value, like I would say at least 3-to-1 ratio, people would not be too angry, because like people are not subscribed to a list to be spam, right? So that's why people don't want to give our email, right? But how can you get over that? It's like you provide them value, right? Even when you sell them something, it's about value first. So nurturing a list, when you get a bigger list, will help you to make more money, because when you nurture a list and you do everything right that provide them value, people would not go away. Then you can sell more and more product. And the phase number 7, which is how you can sell expensive product, which I mean is anything as well, 1500 or more, because most of the people are not buying anything 1500 or more on the internet. I haven't know anyone who would buy anything from Amazon which is 1500 or more, because like when it's come to that price point, people have a natural tendency, they want to attach a face to it. They don't want someone that faceless. They want human interaction. So the best way that you can sell those people who are 1500 or more, which is like either your coaching program or your course or anything, is like you want to have people to sign up on the opt-in page to set up a call time that so salespeople or you can call them to see what are the things that you can offer them and persuade them to see why they should buy it from you. Those is a method that I have tested out, would be a good way to improve the conversion for the higher or expensive item. Those are the 7 steps that everyone who take the customer from completely stranger to a high paying customer. If you like this video, please like this video and subscribe and let me know what do you think. Thank you so much for your time. See you next time.